Hey yo, it's your boy Los. Let's get
remember,
it.
I got packs to move. I hope
Jesus.
God show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down. The only thing that I pray is that my feet don't fail me now. And I don't think there's nothing I could do now to right my wrongs. I want to talk to God, but I'm afraid because we ain't spoken so long. God show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down. Pray is that my feet don't fail me now. And I don't think there's nothing I can do now to right my wrongs. I wanna talk to God, but I'm afraid cause we ain't spoken so long. To the hustlers, killers, murderers, drug dealers, even the scribbles.
Jesus was with them.
To the victims of welfare, feel we living in hell here, hell yeah.
Jesus was with them.
Now I hear he, wanna see thee more clearly. I know he hear me when my feet get weary, cause we're the almost nearly extinct. We rappers as role models, we rap, we don't think. I ain't here to argue about his facial features, but here to convert atheists into believers. I'm just trying to say the way school need teachers, the way Kathleen needed Regis, that's the way I need Jesus. So here go my single doll, radio needs this. They said you can rap about anything except for Jesus. That means guns, sex, lies, videotape. But if I talk about God, my record won't get played, huh? Well, if this take away from my spins, which it probably take away from my ends, then I hope it take away from my sins and bring the day that I'm dreaming about. Next time I'm in the club, everybody screaming out. God show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down.
So as you can see, we're talking this very, very rainy day about Kanye's latest album, Jesus King. Yes, King. Jesus King. And I gotta say, yo, for real, this is the first review that I've gotten or asked to do where like, I got hit up a couple times from people saying, yo, can't wait for your review. I want to hear your two cents on the situation. What's your thoughts? And something I do that I always, and Cass, it was funny, man, because Cass would come to me like, yo, this is what I think. I'm like, yo, chill. Like, I don't want to hear nobody's review. I don't even want to see no Facebook posts. I put a meme up the other day just being funny, but I was a GIF actually being funny, but I was dead serious. Like, I'm me dodging Kanye posts because when I do my reviews, what you hear is from me. You know what I mean? This is, as it says, my two cents. What you're hearing me say is my personal thoughts on it, right? I don't like my thoughts to be mixed in with others. You know what I'm saying? That's your thought. That's your view. You like it. You didn't like it. You thought it was this. Thought it was that. That's, but that's you. You know what I'm saying? Rock with that. You know, this is what you hear from me is what you hear from me. And so I literally had to let Facebook go for a couple of seconds. Actually, let a couple of groups go or just dodge them because it was just everywhere I went on my home. With my home feed was just like, or title, whatever, homepage, yeah. It was just, you know, Kanye, album. I'm just like, yo, I just really want to chill. But shout out to everybody that asked, that was looking for the review. Man, I appreciate you. That means a lot. I know a lot of cats don't care for my reviews or see it as whatever, but shout out to those who rock with me still. Appreciate that, real talk. Just start off this here, man. When I got the album and I was at home getting ready for work, and I hit play, and you know, I ain't gonna lie to you, man, I was shocked. I was shocked and I was in amazement. I thought, you know, I didn't know what to think about the album. I'm not gonna lie to you. I didn't know if it was gonna be maybe some. I hadn't watched anything on Sunday services. I hadn't seen anything. Like, I'm dead serious. Like, when I get ready to do my reviews, I really don't pay attention to anybody else's views or thoughts on the album until I'm done with mine. It's like, oh, okay, yes, yeah, what's up? And so I didn't know what to, I hadn't heard a song, hadn't nothing. And so I can say I was really, really shocked and amazed in awe in a lot of ways about this album as soon as I hit play. Just a well done album, man. I gotta admit, this was just a well done album. Now, well, I'll get that second. Just a well done album. I loved how, you know, it's the song God Is. It's probably my favorite song on the album. mainly because as he's singing the song, like, I could hear him. Not no auto-tune, not no extra ad-libs, break throwing stuff. Nah, I'm hearing him sing with cracked voice the whole nine, but I really gathered that he was really singing from his heart. Like, his soul was crying out for talking about who God is to him. And I was amazed by that. I have to admit, take my hat off to him for that. It was just, you know, I thought he did a great job on that song. And I think for the most part, right, this album as a whole, I think it was him. I think, although he's a baby Christian, right, as we say. And here's the funny part, I don't know when this whole transformation thing began with him, right? I don't know when the Lord used who they used to snatch him up and he finally said, that's what's up, I'm down. I don't know. We thought baby Christian, but he really could have been rocking for a minute. Again, I don't follow Kanye, so I couldn't tell you what he was doing prior to this, like a minute prior to this. I don't know. But what I do know is, from what I'm hearing, is authentic love, authentic desire for God, an authentic desire for others to hear about the beauty of the Lord. And I have to admit, man, I was encouraged, I was strengthened, and I loved it. I'm not a Hezekiah Walker fan, but yeah, boom, he came in singing, I'm like, yes, sir. You know what I'm saying? Did his thing. Kenny G is on the album. My dad grew me up on Kenny G. I'm a huge Kenny G fan. Loved hearing him on the, I messed it up. It's a sax, not the sax, it's a something. I don't know, but you know what he was playing. I loved it. The choir at the beginning, every hour, dope. It was overall a great album, man. I was pleased with everything. On God was a problem for me, because that's, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's basically, when someone says on God, that's usually someone, like, yo, I swear, son, on God, son, like, you know, putting that on God, you know, of course, someone says on God, but it's not a term that I personally rock with. I don't think we should be, as believers, I don't think we should be saying that. It's almost on a level, I see it almost on a level of swearing to God. Like, I swear to God, son, I don't rock with that. So the title of that was. And then the justification of them $4 billion Yeezys, the shoes, you know, I got to feed, I get you got to feed your family. I'm not knocking the whole feed your family situation. I get that firsthand. But I don't know how much food your kids need to eat for $4,000 per shoe. But that's just me, though. You know, I don't know. But I didn't like that part. But I like that song, really. That song kind of bothered me. There's another song. I can't remember. I'm so sorry. I can't remember it. Man, I'm so sorry. But I'll put it up here. But he made reference to the fact that he's on strike. Now, this is, he told Satan, I'm on strike. Now, this could be me nitpicking, and I get that. I didn't like that line, only because the reality of a strike, when a company or like, for instance, was it Chevrolet just went on, the workers went on strike. They went on strike until things changed, and then they came back to that company. You know what I'm saying? And so my hope and prayer is, I'm nitpicking. I can feel it. I'm be honest with you. I'm nitpicking. I just be real with you. I don't like that terminology, though. I don't like that terminology. Just on strike usually means you go back to a thing after something's taken care of or something's right. But I'm doing me. I'll be transparent. I'm doing me. I'm trying to find something, because it's really hard to find anything really, really negative about this album. And I guess I'm searching. I'll be 100 about that. But nah, overall, man, it's a dope album, man. I'm very much encouraged. I praise God for what I'm hearing. What I did hear, for not necessarily about his music, but about him. He's surrounded by some sound, some cats, man. A couple cats that I rock with on Facebook.com/reformbars. One of the guys, pastor, I think is getting it in with him, which is dope. And he's meeting up with cats and linking up now. The whole Jamal Bryant thing, with him going to Utah. I don't want to get political with it, you know what I'm saying? You vote for who you vote for, you rock who you rock with on the political stage. That's neither, to me, that's neither here nor there as far as in this context here. But that pastor tried to, I don't know, it's funny, he tried to be slick. I ain't gonna say slick, but he tried to line himself up with Kanye, like, you're about to do some big things, and many folks feel that was for publicity alone. He's not a sound pastor, and so I'm praying that the Lord would well, I guess another, the little friendship has been severed. We just praise God for that. Also saw that supposedly Joel Osteen wants him to come to his church. Then I saw another thing saying that him and Joel Osteen are cool, they're friends, whatnot. I don't know about that, but praying against that. But other than that, man, I'm encouraged by the amount of cast that circled around him and has been praying for him, praying with him, and encouraging him. He put a clip out, or there was a report out saying that he asked all his everybody on the song to abstain from sex while working on the album. And you know, I praise God for that comment. I didn't read why he was on that, but I can assume. But I just would, in the future, to avoid that, is hire some MCs or some producers or engineers or whatever that happen to already be in love with the Lord, already be engulfed in his beauty and desire for holiness. And so you ain't gotta say, hey, don't sleep around while you do this album, you know what I'm saying? They just automatically have a fear of God and a desire for holiness, and they just strive towards perfection day in and day out. Not saying they're perfect, but they strive for it, and you ain't gotta put that out there like, hey, don't do that. They should already know that. But you know, it's easy here or there. And then someone said, well, he doesn't know, you know, many Christian MCs or Christians on that level. No Malice is a Christian MC who's also on the album. His brother Pusha T as well is on the album with Kenny G. So he could have asked that around. But that's neither here nor there. End of the day, man, dope album. Now, here's a few little things that I didn't like about the album. I think production was cool. A couple songs, like, so the song with the gospel with the clips and Kenny G, that's probably as far as production wise, probably the dopest one on there for me. But the delays, right? So it was supposed to come out like 3 weeks ago, then 2 weeks ago, and then it came out just, you know, last night. And so what bothered me about that was I expected with this long of delays, right, that he was going to just come with just, you know, Kanye, and you know his production, he takes it really serious and so on and so forth. And so I expected more production-wise from him. I even expected more bar-wise from him. He has some great writers. Currency was written for him. Sci High is written for him. I forgot old boy name who wrote Jesus Walks, but what's his name? I see his face. Can't get his name. So sorry. But you know, he wrote that song he wrote Jesus Walks for Kanye, and so he has some great writers, and I think he could have made the songs longer. Most songs are like 2 minutes long. Whatever, that could have made the songs longer. Could have made the bars longer and a little more in depth. Not taking away from what he did do. But I just wish we could have got more for the delays, because it was saying like, oh, he's not finished with it yet. He's adding more to it. He's putting finished touches on this and the third. And I just would have expected more from such a long delay, and expected more from just from Kanye himself. I didn't like that. I didn't like. I'm against 100%. So Kanye is a believer now. Praise God for that. But I am against. I'm just not a fan of secular artists or unbelievers, right, doing songs about how good God is, right? I just don't like that. I personally don't like that. I think that should be reserved for those who have experienced the goodness of the Lord and repented of sins and now seeking after him and his desire, their desire to be holy. And you know, so I think it's on the lines of me saying, you know, that the new Lexus is the dopest Lexus ever, or the dopest car ever made, yet I've never driven the new Lexus. You know what I'm saying? Like, for me, it's like, you haven't experienced the goodness of God yet. You haven't even you haven't had a chance to fully understand or grasp the beauty of the gospel yet. You're rapping about how good the gospel is. You know what I'm saying? So that, I took offense to that. That's just me personal. Just wasn't a fan of that. Now, can't front. Pusha T and No Malice came with it. You know what I'm saying? Lyrically, they killed it. But just the concept, the idea of me knowing that they're not, Pusha T is not a believer yet, talking about, you know, saying the Lord on that level, I didn't like that. But yeah, like I said, I did expect more production-wise for such a long delay. Production was cool. It was all right. But, you know, I just expected more. I can't get over, man, his Man, that song Chick-fil-A is pretty dope too, man. Or Closed on Sunday, sorry. Pretty dope, man. When he said Jezebel don't even stand a chance, that blessed my heart, man. It really did, man. Because as a man of God, basically telling, and a man of God on his level, his level of stardom, you know what I'm saying? Telling chicks, yo, don't even try it. That blessed me, man. I praise God for that, man. And the line when he said, All We Need. He's all I need. We have everything. He basically told, and Adam should have told Eve, put that fruit back, man. We got everything we need. I was like, Father. I was like, for real, man, because it was dope, man. That blessed my heart, man, to hear him say that. You know what I'm saying? But I gotta be honest about something else though, right? And this is just me. Although everything he said was dope, man. I wonder if us in the Christian community, if we're just running towards this album because of who said it, right? Once again, not taking nothing away from what he said. And like I said, the album is dope. I'm rocking with the album. I'm a bump this album. But I wonder if we're really excited about this album because of who said it, right? I wonder this though, right? I wonder if Stephen Brendel, Stephen the Levite, Result, Evangel, Lecrae, Thizzle, who dropped the album as well yesterday, who, Humble Beast, Jason, Flame, you name it, right? Evangel, did I say Evangel? If not, Evangel, Barlow, Garion, Stevens, whoever, right? Whoever name you want to throw into that pot, right? If they drop an album tomorrow saying the exact same things that Kanye said, would we be as excited? That's a question in my mind. That's a personal question for me. Because like I said, I got excited on this album. Like I said, I heard the album and I rejoiced and like, wow, Lord, look at you. Do your thing, Lord. I ain't mad. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying that kind of stuff. And I'm not even necessarily glorifying Kanye. I'm more so just rejoicing at the goodness of the Lord to save Kanye. As I did when he saved me. As I do when he saved my homies. To me, it's the same. I know many are kind of like, oh, treating this like it's an overall phenomenal thing, and it is because of salvation, but I'm the same joy I have for Kanye I had for my man, you know what I'm saying? And so if they said these words, would we be as excited? Would we screenshot it? I don't know, and I don't think so. But I think a lot of it has to do with the fact of who said these words. I think a lot of it has to do with the fact that Kanye, who at one point in time thought he was Jesus, is now bowing his knee to Jesus. And I don't know. And I guess for me, that's me wrestling with myself. And it's not saying don't get excited about what's being said. It's not me saying don't find joy in what's being said. But I think it's important that we rejoice more so in what's being said as opposed to who's saying what's being said. I think the truth in those words are powerful. Powerful no matter who says them. And I think a lot of times we're just like, oh, Kanye said... Which is dope, because it was said, but I'm more leaning towards what was said as opposed to who said what was said. If that makes any sense. Still wrestling with that in my mind, so it probably didn't come out correctly. If it didn't, I apologize. But at the end of the day, man, real talk, I give this album an 8 out of 10. Dope album. I'm a fan of it. Praise God for what the Lord is doing in Kanye, man. I pray for his wife and his kids and his family and, you know what I'm saying, the those who were in the studio as he was rapping these songs and they was being singing or being sung, sorry. I pray that the Lord used it. I pray that the Lord uses this album and it draws people in to the Lord, not to Kanye, but to the Lord. You know what I'm saying? I pray that many hear this album and just who've never heard the gospel before, you know what I'm saying, and fall to their knees and repent of sins and, you know what I'm saying? And I pray that God gets all the glory, man. I pray that, man, Yeah, man. I'm looking forward to what's gonna come around the corner from this album. Yeah, dope album. Other than the little things that I said, I don't really have a problem with this album. Good album, man. Yeah. Very much impressed, yo. Can't front. I'm a very skeptical person. I ain't gonna lie to you. Anybody that knows me or follows me, I'm a very, you know, jump on you type. I'm a very skeptical person, but I gotta say, yo, this album here was very encouraging. I was in the gym just a second ago, and I'm just, yeah, I'm getting it, man. Dope album. Praise God, man. Real talk. All right, y'all. All right, y'all. Grace. Dope album, man.